So you probably heard of Miro, which is a collaborative whiteboard for teams. It lets teams join together and visualize what's going on the whiteboard. It helps them view in shapes, text, writing, and different kind of things, even webcam, okay? But this deal is different to Miro because it's in a lifetime deal, which it makes it a sweet deal, right? And what I'm gonna do in this video is I'm gonna show you HuddleIQ, the deal, and how it actually works. So let's go jump over to my desktop right now. Hey, what's up everyone? My name is George and this is SaaS Master. Today we're gonna check out HuddleIQ, and what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna show you first the deal and then we're gonna jump over to my HuddleIQ dashboard. The deal starts off at $79 for the lifetime deal, and if you guys wanna grab it, that link will be provided in the description. It lets you create a bunch of things in whiteboard, and it's an alternative to Miro and Miro. I know those are top dogs, and yes, well, those are month-to-month paid, and this one is on a lifetime deal, which makes it a sweet deal. I know there might be some things missing, but that's expected when you are buying one of these deals that are newer. Miro has like a domain age of 26 years, so they've been around for a long time, and these guys have been around for 3 years. So there's the things to consider, okay? Now, what do you get with those $79 on a lifetime deal? Right now, you are gonna get tied to the premium plan, which is their top plan as of this video. Things might change in the future. You get 500 gigabytes of upload storage, 100 megabytes maximum file upload size. So that's each upload file size and the rest, okay? Now for the single code, which is $79, you get access to 5 members. Those are where the limits come when it comes to the stacking of these codes, okay? But the rest is all the same. So you get unlimited boards, unlimited guests, unlimited editors, unlimited commenters, and or viewers. So basically, all of that is unlimited. If you don't need more team members than 5, you are good to go with this $79 deal, because you're getting unlimited for all of this. I mean, you can share the link, they can go view the whiteboard, you can share for editors, commenters, and viewers, and you don't have to worry about that because it's unlimited. Okay, you get unlimited private or shared projects, unlimited objects per board, the whole 9 yards. If you need more members, like members that actually are working inside of the dashboard, then you need to jump into double code, multiple code, and all the way up to 10 codes, which gives you 50 members, which is a whole lot. I know most of us will do fine with the single code, which is $79 for one of these, okay? Now, let me jump into my HuddleIQ dashboard. This is the main page for HuddleIQ. I will leave the link in the description just in case you guys wanna check it out. This is my dashboard for HuddleIQ. I can create a new board, which is what I'm going to do first on this video. Let me go ahead and start off right now. And I'm gonna say test for video. That's what I'm gonna call it. And I'm gonna send it over to my projects. I can invite people. I can add an icon to this just in case I wanna find it later on easily, because once you have a bunch of boards, like I don't know, 20, 30 boards, well, it's gonna be hard to find. But once you have those images, it makes it easier. You also have the search feature. So let's wait for this to load and I'll continue this video. There we go. We are loading now into the templates section. Now be aware that my internet is really bad. This is not on the HuddleIQ side, okay? So these are the templates that are available. You have categories on the left. You can also search. So depending on what you need, well, basically you can grab one of those templates unless you want to start off with a clean white board, okay? So in this case, there's recommended ones. So if you need to use this for meetings, retrospective, brainwriting, customer persona, etc., you got all of these available. You got brainstorming, you got those available. Problem solving, there's a little bit of mind map there. Here's another one, flow chart. I wish they had some templates for mind maps that kind of already works out, where they have already some shapes built into it, so it makes it easier to get started. So let's use one of these recommended ones, and we can use any of these, I mean, just for testing purposes. Customer journey map. Let's go ahead and select this one, and it's loaded into my section right there. I can go ahead and grab this and it'll move it around. So you can see the little hand. If I hover over an object, I can select it. But if I click away, I have the hand. If I use, well, I'm on a Mac. If I use my 2 fingers, I can zoom in and out. I can grab these elements, I can select it, and I can move them around. So if I need to add it right there, that is possible. Now, some of the things that I dislike about HuddleIQ is that the lock feature to kind of center things it's a little bit off. So if I go a little bit to the top, it takes me all the way there. So you can see there, I'm having trouble kind of aligning it to the center. And I think that's something that's really important in this kind of system with whiteboards, especially when you're using shapes, because you want to create a nice, clean mind map or one of these, what am I using? Schedulers, to kind of center it. The things that you could do is you can use the keyboard to move these around to fine tune the section. And those are the things that I find interesting, okay? So there you go. I have selected one of these elements and I can go ahead and size it. I can change the color of the background. I can add some text color right there. Add text properties to links and all that information. If I click on it, I'll get the text properties. Right now there's no text in it, but if I do write on it, you'll see there. It's writing with it. There we go. Change the shape size. So if I want to make a triangle, that is possible. Change it to another one. I can create a slide with this. If I want to create it in towards a presentation, I can duplicate it. I can delete it. I can lock it, because some of these elements you don't want to move around, or maybe you have something that's kind of on top of the other one. So it's really a nice idea to lock it just in case you don't move it by mistake. Okay. Selecting container cell and fit to screen. This is to fit the whole thing to screen in case you want to work with that. And this goes along with all the shapes that we select here. We can move them around. We have some smiley faces there that we can drag in from the top row over here from the menu. But you can work with this whiteboard really easily. Now I can select from the pointer from hand or selector. I can write on this. Now, the reason you're viewing this and I'm writing on it is because if I do a live presentation where I have my webcam activated and I have my teammates looking at this, well, they're actually viewing what's going on. Okay, so I can write on something and just say, hey, you know what? Hey, take a look at this, okay? I can go ahead and remove, there you go, get rid of that. Clean look, add some text, add some sticky notes. So like the ones you saw right now, here's another one. I can just drop it there and I can start writing with it. There you go. I can add some comments to this. So for example, if there's something that I have to comment during my presentation or beforehand, well, I can just click on this and say the topic is video and write the comment. For example, I'll say check video length. All right, post it, there we go. And you can comment on this and other team members can comment on this also. So you have like a chat inside of this comment. I'll click away from it and we have this little comment icon. I can move this around depending on where I want it. So for example, if the comment has to do with these faces, well, I'll do it right there. So now my team knows that this icon has to do with comments. And if I click on it, well, I'm able to view what's going on. So check length. I can write another comment like, I don't know, say done. I can post it and it should be there. Click on it, there we go. It's been added there and it gives me the time, the day and time, which is really important for this when you're collaborating with other team members. Okay, so next thing we got is cards. If I wanna add cards there, and add that card, whoops. There we go, grabbed it. And we can enter a title for that card. We can add a task to it. We can comment and attach, so we can add task to it. Oh, I wanna get rid of it. I'll just say test right now. Okay, get rid of it there. I can just click on delete. Type, actually delete, and it'll go away. I can do resources. For example, there's emojis, like the ones you saw right now. There's icons, icons from AWS, icons from Kubernetes. I don't know how to say that, but it's available there. And if you click on these, like vector graphics, you gotta click on it, wait a bit, and it'll start loading those vector graphics that we can use on our presentation right here. That's gonna take a bit to load because of my internet. So if I search for cows, there we go. So we got some vectors graphics for that, okay? Now that's part of this system, okay? So we built the presentation and, well, what's next? We wanna invite guests, users, collaborators, commenters, whatever. Well, that is possible by clicking on this little icon on the top. So right here, I can go ahead and select members to invite. So if I have members previously added there, I can invite them. Copy members link, copy guest board link, and those guest board, what can they do? Are they only going to view? So that's possible by selecting there. Can they, is this a guest link for commenters or editors? So in this case, I'll say view, copy the link. I'll go into incognito mode. Let's head on over to that board. This is me, I'm not logged in. This is incognito mode. And I'll just say, guest for video. Click on it. There we go. It should be loading the presentation that I've just been working on this video. So let's give it some time to load. There we go. I can start a tour for this, but in this case, I just want to view it. And there we go. What I've been playing around on this whiteboard, I'm as a guest, only a viewer for this because that's the permission that I allowed. And I'm able to view it right there. I have some things like go to home, like dashboard, full screen to make it blown up. I can zoom in, zoom out. Attendees for this, there's also a chat option. Well, there's a commenter. The comments that you will see on display. So for example, there we go. And it's gonna hover over that comment. There's the chat for this. In this case, it's just a viewer. There's the polls. If there was a poll available, we're able to view the polls there. Just in case you wanna say, hey, what do you guys think of image one and image two? Or what do you think about starting Monday or Tuesday? And then you'll have a poll there to work with. And there's a map just to view there. If you wanna go to someplace special, you have this map to view there. Okay, let me get out of this incognito mode. Okay, I'm back here. But you see how easy that was? That's one of the main things about HuddleIQ is collaborating with teams and sharing that link so they can also view it. Now, what if you want to make a presentation where you're actually on webcam and you're talking about what's going on and you're moving your whiteboard as you go along? Well, on the bottom, there's another menu right here. There's the video conference. So if I click on it, oops, I clicked on it twice. Okay, here's a video conference. I'm going to select my FaceTime camera. There we go, my green screen, you can see that there. Webcam enabled when the conference starts, I can turn it off if I like. Select the device for audio, so it's the main audio, the speakers, etc. I can start the video conference. In this case, I already gave it access to my camera and the microphone. If you haven't done that previously, it will ask you for permission. Okay, so here is my cam right there. And if I share this link again with other collaborators, with teams, with viewers and all that, they're actually viewing the presentation and I'm viewing what I'm talking about right there. They can also come in and also with their webcam. I won't be able to do this because I'm using the webcam as I'm showing you this video, but it is possible with other users. So it's pretty cool that we have this feature. You can also share screen in currently off. Webcam is on currently on. I can turn it off. I can turn off my microphone. The basic features that you would get on any type of presentation with webcam. I'll turn that off there. There's also the presentation mode, which is, well, presentation. Here's the options for presentation mode if you guys want to check that out. There's a slides mode. There's the comments list that we saw previously on the guest. The chat, if I want to chat here. So I just say test, send it over. There we go. There's the task timer. If you have task enabled, I can enable a task for something that we're working on and that's available there. The polls. So in this case, I am actually the editor, so I can create a poll for this and I can create this poll to say, poll name. I don't know. I'll just name a question and I could say, hey, you know what? What do you think of? Is it Huddle with, no, just Huddle IQ. Okay, and it's going to be opened up for 2 hours and 0 minutes, and I can change that to more time. Do I like it? Yes. Do I like it? No. And I can add more answers to that. Start the poll. There we go. And it just started. So when people jump in, they're able to obviously vote for the poll. So like I mentioned before, maybe you're voting for something like which image do you like the most? What day is the best day for this, etc. Whatever you want to use the poll for. And again, we also have the map in case you want to move around inside of there. But basically, that is HuddleIQ. Like I mentioned before, it's similar to Miro, but obviously there will be missing some things because, I mean, Miro is top dog and they've been around for several years. But if you're looking something in a lifetime deal where you're only paying once and you don't have to pay month to month and you know that the features that you are viewing right now, it's enough, well, it's a good deal for you. But there you go. That's a deal that's going on right now. If you guys want to check it out, that link will be provided in the description. It helps me out with a small commission, but it won't cost you a single cent more. It helps me out to make these videos and, well, it helps me. I thank y'all for watching. My name is George and this is SaaS Master. I'll see you guys later.